one of the mandates clearly of the new board is to look at sustainability of the institution and its financial viability. And for a long time, even when I was in the Treasury, one of the things that we said to Eskom is don't just keep demanding higher tariffs, also look at the cost base of Eskom. And so that's what Mr. Mabuza has been talking about in his remarks, because without looking at the cost base, there isn't an endless potential for revenue to increase. You can see actually demand falling, which is something that needs to be analyzed a lot more carefully. Why is demand falling at this point in time, and where is it coming from? Is it coming from industry, from households? Has half of South Africa gone to Australia, or what's the issue that we are currently confronted with? So clearly, in terms of long-term strategy, you want a viable organization, you want a well-governed organization. We need to understand where the economy is going and guarantee that we will not have a repeat of the 2010-11 period, where load shedding became a fetter on growth. And there's absolutely no doubt that at least 1% of GDP was deducted from the growth that South Africa potentially could have achieved by the fact that we had load shedding at that particular point in time. And so that's still another issue that we need to get into at some point in time. So financial and organizational sustainability. Secondly, matching the economic growth and the inclusivity factor. Thirdly, ensuring that all citizens in South Africa have affordable electricity, whether it is through Eskom's own doing or in combination with the free basic services that government pays for, and how that meets our requirements. And as human settlements begin to settle down into some kind of pattern, particularly in the peri-urban areas, the supply in those areas as well. And then fourthly, the question of, as I said earlier on, is everything in the Eskom stable that which you require to run Eskom on an efficient and cost-effective basis? But fifth is to begin to at least anticipate the next 5 to 10 years in some way and have a roadmap of sorts, on the understanding that as circumstances change, that roadmap might well have to be adjusted in a very transparent way so the South African public can understand where we are going. Now, in that context, remember two factors were mentioned as key cost drivers. One is staff costs and the other is coal costs or primary energy costs. And I think there's still a lot of work to be done on the primary energy cost side, because that was the side that got Gupta-rized in some form. And the implications of that we actually saw on the 10th of May when we visited the Hendrina power plant. And there were two conveyor belts from the optimum mine to supply directly to the Hendrina power plant. Those conveyor belts were sitting still. And endless lines of trucks were bringing coal from elsewhere. And then, of course, you now have business rescue and all the gymnastics that go with that as well. And that's the cost that South Africa has had to pay because of the manner in which the then Eskom board and the then Eskom management decided to sell South Africa's silverware to guys who have actually undermined our economy and undermined this institution, both from within and from outside as well. So I think we need some serious talking to be done and serious strategizing to be done between suppliers of coal and Eskom as a major consumer of coal in South Africa. So in a sense, I'm giving notice on behalf of Eskom that it's time to talk. It's time not to play around with primary energy supply to Eskom on the basis that if it suits a particular mine at a particular point in time because foreign prices are higher, then you divert local coal supplies to foreign supplies and make money out of that. and then begin to sacrifice the kind of stability that we require within the Eskom context. So both the board and the management will be looking into those sorts of issues as well.